Mini chapter 50, Jaymi creates Kim's appearance. Jaymi pulls his study terrace doors closed to shut out the sound of some noisy bird hidden in the foliage of the canyon, whose call sounds like harsh mockery of everything he's trying to achieve in this house on Electra Drive. Returning to the hot seat at his computer, he emits a mirthless laugh aloud. It would seem that despite the sporadic therapy he's had since his early teens, nothing more than a bird is required to pry the lid off all those insecurities yet again. After all, it's surely just paranoia to imagine that a bird would even be able to think that of him, let alone actually think so, isn't it? Yes, it is. Okay, back to work now. He closes his eyes and thinks back to that unique half minute when he let his gaze wander up and down the trivia score, wacky or boring, newsfeed, where new posts were popping up every few seconds, every one of them receiving scores and comments from multiple sources. Then he reopens his eyes, consults his growing design for the Imagination Thief, and checks his sketch for Kim's visuals. Its first description of Kim's physical appearance reads, quote, "He's a young white man in his 20s, whose blonde, cropped hair, handsome face and shirtless body make up a generically attractive ensemble. As I watch him, however, this generic allure starts to assume its place as packaging for a content richer and subtler than expected. There's a quietness, seriousness, and simplicity to his movements and expressions as he serves customers, which suggest a considerable emotional vulnerability under the watchful care of a rather greater strength, coupled with a touch of sadness somewhere." Unquote. There is then one further little artwork-oriented description of him a bit later on. Quote, "In the corner, there he was, a handsome, masculine, blonde boy, slightly sad-eyed, deep in thought, biting his nails as he read the menu." Unquote. Okay then. Kim swims up from abstraction and looks about him. From his looking, there spreads a field of quiet intelligence, and Jaymi expands into a feeling of warm clarity in allowing his own apprehension of this as civilization. This is a boy inclined to ponder the world while he travels it alone at night, his face reflected close upon the window of the train, while the lights in the night slide by him outside, coloured points on the land, squinting in at him between the drops of rain on the glass. See ahead through his life to a night when he sits in a parked car, lit by a candle in the ashtray, in silence. Further on, another time, somewhat stoned and near to sleep, Kim hears a car pass fast on the street beyond the window, as if along a lonely road cut through a forest. The car's sound is warningless and shocking, like a burst of sealed metal laughter, eerie, as of children locked in a tank, and it's gone. Then, white balustrades underneath grey sky, yellow light somewhere, threat of rain, silver birches blowing in a sudden wind, and walking, always walking somewhere, walking on alone. Luxury of solitude, figure in the distance, fit for a painting. But now, other people start appearing in his visuals. First, there he is, still alone at night, but on city streets instead, with car tires hushing over wet black tarmac. Music plays grand and lush across the rainy city, where a voice sings the track's title question, "Do I have to?" Borne aloft on a wash of sound that hollows out around these words a space of yearning solitude solely his own. Hovering in quiet shadow, once again at night, looking down on an old place, a college dining hall, where thousands of lives had chattered through without reflecting on this space they were chatting in, everyone looming so important in their own self, striving, rising, failing, struggling, laughing, rising, failing once again, and then dying. Spirits from the past and dancing spirits yet to come, while this hall remains unchanged. A babbling horde of bodies, all sprung from the earth, and all due back there as soon as they've completed their allotted episodes of waking, sleeping, walking, talking, listening, crying, making love, making coffee, laughing, masturbating, looking to the future, remembering the past, and then at last fading out. In the supermarket queue, clutching alcohol, Kim shuts his eyes, beeping scanners at the tills, a whirring fan, metal trolleys, chopped words, chinks of coinage, and the tearing of receipts. There he stands in his bright blue jeans and his fuzzy smooth white sweater, blonde and clean and serious-eyed, a shy college student or a wholesome-looking pop star. Later, in his own room, just around midnight, euphoric after wine and grass, laughter and talk in the company of friends, cigarette smoke swerving to rise through a lampshade, pulled by convection past a hot red light bulb. Candlelight, music, a view into a court through a low leaded window and mauve speckled lilies on the coffee table, given to him yesterday, a present from his dear friend, the friend called the Queen of Light. Golden years, his talents and his hopes and his life all ahead. Then comes an odd feeling Sunday noon. Still somewhat drunk from the night before, he sits on the low wall just out front, perhaps the only time he does so, in among the tourists and the bicycles. Church bells rain down, bright sun shines, and there's frost on the grass behind the wall where he sits. He lights a cigarette, takes a drag, and feels his head spin inside from the cold air. The gateway on his right is thronged with visitors, among whose more forgettable masses he is startled and warmed to see a figure whom he's at a genuine loss to parse as anything other than a hermaphrodite. A pair of prominent breasts are covered by clothing that's unisex, tending to male, underneath a face whose lack of facial hair in no way diminishes the impression of a maleness so straightforward as to be quite befuddling in the context. The figure disappears in the throng, and Kim looks away again. Squinting into the sunlight, he is struck by something he has never heard more clearly than now, behind the familiar soundscape of clicking bicycle wheels and snatches of speech. Silence, hanging loud, staring out from empty space. Jaymi taps the backup command on his keyboard in sober exhilaration. Okay then, Kim is looking a whole lot more visible now. Just a quick final trio of adornments, and then this beast's artwork should be ready. First, he establishes Kim's gleaming detail in The Imagination Thief as being a high, small balcony whose visuals will appear in the gameplay as a signal of farewell. Quote, high upon the facade, ellipsis, a small traditional balcony with balusters, rather tight and somber, unquote. He then establishes Kim's talisman in The Imagination Thief as being a pair of opera glasses whose visuals Kim will brandish in the gameplay as a spy. Quote, a pair of antique opera glasses, ellipsis. I'm a couple of blocks away from Pippa's with these old opera glasses that Chigem's borrowed, and a few seconds ago I was looking through them at Pippa's balcony and there did seem to be a figure in the shadows just behind her window. It was the same weaselly size as the figure I saw on the balcony with her the other night. Unquote. And he concludes by establishing Kim's additional motif in The Imagination Thief as being a keyhole, whose visuals Kim will peek through with terror in the gameplay. Quote, a faint light coming through the hinge, though you couldn't see through. There was a big keyhole in the door, and I felt a really strong urge to look through. So I bent down and peered in, and I nearly screamed because inside was... ellipsis. I stopped dead when I was halfway down to the keyhole, because right there in front of my face, on the door handle, was this small smear of stickiness. Ellipsis. It would have had to come out about me snooping through keyholes and spying on her with opera glasses. Unquote. Jaymi saves his work and sits back. A subtle new feeling of balance pervades him, as if from a confirmation or vindication that there is, after all, some external standard of reasonable construal that can be relied upon in this world, conceptual, verbal, urbane, and honest. For there is that, right? He can almost taste what a refreshing draught of cool water the quiet equilibrium of Kim's presence will provide in The Imagination Thief. And one thing's for sure, Shigem is one lucky boy to have a Kim like this one created for the pleasure they will give to each other.